Billy Joe? Billy Joe?
Yeah, leave me alone.
Come on, Billy Joe. Sit up now. Sit up and drink some coffee, Billy Joe. You need it. Come on. Billy Joe? Here, drink this. Come on.
Steaks!
Drink, Billy Joe.
Drink, that's what I need. Where's my bourbon?
No, come on. You've had enough of the bottle, Billy Joe. Now drink this. I need your help.
Help? You need my help? I can help you.
Come on,
I can help you away. Nobody else can help you.
No, Billy Joe, stop it, Billy Joe. Stop it. I'm talking about a job. I want a job, and you said you were going to help me,
Billy
Joe.
I'm going to keep you busy 24 hours in the sanctuary.
Billy Joe, you stop it. I'm talking about a singing job. Now, that's what you said you were going to help me with.
I'm going to help you. I'm going to help you like you never helped me before.
Billy Joe, let go. Billy Joe, stop it. Let go of me. You pig! You pig!
And that little piggy came right over here. Come
stop
here!
Stop it! Let
come here,
go.
Girl! Come here!
Let go!
Come here,
of me. You are disgusting! Look what you have done to me! You know something? You can't help me. You could not help anybody.
Well, wait a minute.
Texas, starring Beverly McKenzie.
Steve, settle down now. Come on, settle down.
Well,
there's no word on Alina.
Oh, Lord, I thought sure you'd found her by now.
Well, we just hadn't had time to look for her, that's all.
You haven't had time?
No, you see,
Your little sister is out there somewhere where she doesn't belong, and you haven't had time to look for her.
Well, it's not like it sounds, Kate.
Oh, isn't it?
No.
Oh, something more important, making demands on your time. Is that it, boy? Now, that's not the Max Decker I know.
Kate, something has happened.
Something's happened. I don't understand. If you don't know where Alina is, how can you know that something's happened to her?
It's not Alina, but it's something that you've got to know about.
Well, stop pussyfooting around about it, girl. Tell me straight.
Grandma, it's Uncle Justin. The police came
there today. Steve, I think you better go to bed.
Police? Justin? Oh, is that boy playing hero again? Is
no,
he hurt?
They arrested him.
Steven!
See,
Okay, Mom, I know.
That boy's imagination won't quit. That was just his imagination talking, wasn't it? Now tell me, was there some truth in this?
Oh, Kate, I wish there was an easy way to tell you this.
Well, I've had bad news before. I reckon I can take this. Just tell me.
Well, at
the wedding.
Alex Wheeler's wedding.
Yeah.
Oh, Lord, you don't mean to tell me that Justin had to hound that man on his own wedding day. Is that it? Did he go shooting off his mouth again about Alex Wheeler and Mike's suicide and all that revenge business? Disturbing the peace.
It's a whole lot worse than that.
After the judge pronounced Iris and Alex husband and wife, at that very moment, there was noise and broken glass and blood.
Blood?
Alex Wheeler was shot.
Oh, Lord.
They think Justin did it.
No.
Yeah, Rena's going after Stryker to do the lawyering.
Well, now, Justin's a hothead. But once he gets started on something, it's hard to cool him off. But shooting a man...
I know it's hard to swallow, but the police think he did it.
Well, they'll learn different. What about Alex Wheeler?
I don't know. It's hard to say. There was a lot of blood, and they rushed him off to the hospital. He took a rifle shot, Kate.
And Justin?
Steve was right. The police took Justin away.
Justin?
Kate. At the very least, he's going to be charged with attempted murder.
This way. Hey. Sorry.
What's the charge?
Assault with a deadly weapon. Attempted murder. Hey, hold it. I should check with Gulf Coast Hospital on this one. That Wheeler guy was in real bad shape.
Yeah, give him a call. The guy didn't make it to the hospital. No use writing this one up twice. Make it murder one.
Have you been able to contact Dr. Courtney Marshall yet?
Kevin?
Thank you. Courtney, I'm glad you're still here this late.
I had details that had to be taken care of.
Details?
I was checking on my patient.
Jeb Hampton?
Yes. Kevin, you know how tentative he's been about this heart valve replacement. Well, he's been especially edgy lately, and I wanted to give him a little emotional boost. I mean, he is family and all.
That's very compassionate, Courtney. Whatever reason you're here, I'm very glad. We have emergency surgery. I'd like you to assist.
I'd be happy to assist
Good.
You, Kevin.
We've got a lot to talk about, so let's get started.
But I can't. I think you should find somebody else
you
to
can.
Assist.
Somebody else? It's not like you.
I have priorities here, Kevin. My own patient.
Hampton again?
Kevin, he's left the hospital. I think I should find him and get him back.
Courtney, I wish you'd stop fretting about Jeb Hampton. You're beginning to sound like a frustrated mother hen. Now, his surgery is elective. We have an emergency here.
Kevin, his feelings and fears are serious matters, too.
How serious is this? Look at that x-ray.
Oh, my Lord. Kevin, these look like my father's x-rays when he was shot.
The wound is similar. And potentially is lethal. The patient is Alex Wheeler. Good.
I'm Jeb Hampton. I'm Jenny's brother. I was here once before. Remember?
Of course you are. I don't know, honey. My mind must be slipping. I guess those tequila fumes are finally getting to me.
Well, maybe. I was just here once, ma'am.
I know, so. But I ought to remember that once because you punched out a little weasel for us.
Yeah, well, that weasel, I'm looking for him right now. You have an idea where he is?
Billy Joe?
Yeah.
Well, the last time you saw him was the day he got his walking papers, and so far as I know, he is still walking.
You don't have any idea where he might have walked to, do you?
Probably as far away as he could get. But unfortunately, that just isn't far enough. He did tell me to refer all of his important business calls to the Top of the World Club. He works there as a bartender at nights. He'd like to make you think he owns the place.
You think he'd be there now?
Well, either there or under a rock somewhere. Hey, listen, how come you are looking for Billy Joe? I mean, much as I like to see him get his comeuppance, I think he had enough comeuppance already from you.
No, listen, I'm not after blood. You see, I'm looking for this girl.
Oh, honey, any girl Billy Joe Wright would fix you up with, you wouldn't want.
No, it's a specific girl, you understand? She lives out on the ranch.
The only girl I know at the ranch is Elena Decker.
Yeah, that's her. You know her.
Do I know her? I'm Elena's aunt, and I'm worried sick about her. But what makes you think she would be with Billy Joe?
No reason.
There must be some reason.
Look, I've just heard her mention him a few times, that's all.
Well, now, if you've heard Elena mention Billy Joe Wright, you must have heard her mention some other people. Why aren't you out checking up on them?
Well, you gotta start somewhere, so I'm gonna go on over to...
Wait a minute! I hear something, and I don't like what I hear one little bit.
Look, Maggie, I don't know any more than you do. That's why...
That's what I don't like. Now, I get a feeling that old Aunt Maggie is being kept in the dark about something. And you wouldn't know anything about this now, would you, Nita?
Nobody'd want to keep you in the dark, Maggie.
I think I hear a great big unless in there.
What do you mean?
I mean, nobody would want to keep you in the dark, Maggie, unless it was for your own good, or unless it was to protect Elena. Now, you listen to me, girl. If Elena has been messing around with that husband of yours, or former husband, or whatever he is, then she is going to need protecting, and not from me either.
Well, Elena would never fool around with Billy Joe.
You don't sound too sure about that. As a matter of fact, now that I think of it, that might be just why she run away. I can't imagine where she'd get a foolish notion like that.
Look, Maggie, I know that nothing has happened between Elena and between Elena and Billy Joe.
Not yet, you mean.
And there's never gonna be. I noticed that there was something happening between them.
My little Elena and Billy Joe Wright.
But Maggie, she promised. She promised me she would not see him again.
Again? You mean she already has?
No, I mean, she just thought about it before. But she promised me. She promised me she wouldn't see him. And I believe her. I mean, she wouldn't break a promise. Not to me.
Of course I wouldn't.
Oh, honey, am I glad to see you.
Well, there you go, Maggie. And she's just fine, aren't you, Elena?
Yeah. Well, why wouldn't I be? I'm a big girl. I'm big enough to take care of myself. And I know enough not to go anywhere near a guy like Billy Joe. Honest, I wouldn't.
Well, Lord knows I've had enough of that city for one night. I gotta go back in. See what I can find out about that little sister of mine.
Best you do, Max. I'll be fine here.
Yeah, well, don't you worry too much, yeah?
Striker. Oh, Max. How's she doing?
Pretty good, considering.
Kate, Rena filled me in. I couldn't be sorrier.
You know, it's funny. I keep wondering what Mr. Marshall would have to say about all this. Probably just about as much as I do. Not much.
Kate, there's some explanation.
Yes, I expect so, but I'm afraid to hear what it is.
Honey, what I mean is that there's some explanation to what happened to Alex Wheeler. Justin is innocent. I know he is.
I'm gonna help the boy any way I can.
To prove he's innocent?
Well, let's just take one thing at a time now, Kate. We gotta get bail for Justin, or at least try.
Try? I mean, he might have to spend the night in jail?
He might have to spend more than one night, honey.
You mean if...
If Alex pulls through, we'll be able to get bail for Justin. Now, let's just take one thing at a time.
You'll need a lot of money for that bail, won't you, Stryker?
I'm afraid so, Kate.
I'm afraid there's not much in the bank anymore.
Kate, you shouldn't be worrying about money at a time like this. Let Stryker and I take care of the bail.
Oh, no. Thank you, Rena. I'll get the deed to this place and give Stryker power of attorney to pledge it.
Poor Kate, the ranch, you can't do that. Honey, let us take care of it for you, please. Consider it a loan.
Oh, Rena, you can be sweet and kind when the chips are down. But no, honey. This is a family matter. And that's what this place is. Family. You know, the ranch has always been our source of strength. And with what's happened to us now that we have to face, we're gonna need all the strength that we can get. first thing is to get Justin out of that jail cell. And I want to do that myself with a little help from Marshall Ranch. Stryker, if you'll come on into the parlor with me now, I'll open up my safety box.
Right.
And I'll hang around and drive you all to the police station.
Thanks.
Come on, you want a revenge? Look at him!
No. I know you won't believe it. It wasn't me. I swear.
Coward! Murderer! You will pay for this! For every drop of blood you took from him, you will pay!
Please, you've got to get this man to the hospital.
No!
Hold it. What is it?
No!
What can we do?
No, not Justin, not him.
But look, he even had the rifle, sir.
No, don't you believe it? No, I knew his father. I loved his father. No, shoot a man in the back? No. No, not Mike Marshall's son.
Oh, please, no. That's enough now. Please move out of the way.
Wrong about everything I thought was right. Alex Wheeler. Alex Wheeler. Alex Wheeler is another man, not the one I've been carrying around in my head. What happened to that Alex Wheeler, the one who destroyed my father? Was that the Alex Wheeler who absolves me because I am Mike Marshall's son? Absolves when everyone else accuses? Absolves me? Because of the respect he holds for my father? I've been wrong before. So wrong. I'm sorry, Alex Wheeler.
These folks have statements to make in the Wheeler shooting. You want to get a steno to take it down?
Here?
It's where we usually do it.
In front of him?
Shy?
Hey, pal, that guy is dangerous.
You're in a police station, mister. Not too much is gonna happen to you here.
I don't know what kind of police station it is if you think you can let killers roam around on the loose. Now, he ought to be locked up.
Clipper, I think these policemen know what they're doing.
Now, if you'll repeat what you told me, the steno will take your statement. Miss, we'll start with you.
Look, it's very confusing.
Tell him, Terry.
Will you excuse us, please? Justin.
The man who shot Alex Wheeler?
We don't know that. He's also the man who saved Ricky's life, not to mention mine.
Look, I know it's hard, baby, but you have to. That's your duty to Alex.
But Alex asked me not to tell anyone. I can't betray Alex either.
But things are different now, baby. If you had told the police about her back then, I mean, Look, I'm not blaming you. You were just following Wheeler's orders. But Wheeler could have saved himself a lot of grief. Now we've got to do what we can do. Now, come on, honey. You start out and tell him about the night that Justin came after Wheeler with a gun. And then I'll tell him about all the crazy things that I've heard him say lately.
You tried to warn Ricky?
You're damn straight I did.
Why wouldn't he listen? Why didn't he just listen to you, Clipper?
He was following orders, baby. He didn't want to interrupt the ceremony.
If he just listened, he could have saved Alex.
Hey, you can't blame him either. You know, after all, I haven't exactly been in anybody's good graces around the world building lately.
But they were wrong. I was wrong. We all were. You tried to save Alex. Ricky just wouldn't listen.
Can't blame anybody, baby. Except the man who pulled the trigger. So the faster we tell him what we know, the faster there'll be justice.
Alex, when he gets better, I'm gonna tell him about this. He'll see how wrong he was. When he gets better. He has to get better.
He sure does, baby. He sure does.
Dr. Cook.
What is it?
I'm coming with you.
I know how concerned you are, Connor, but I'm afraid I can't permit that.
Oh, that has a familiar ring, doesn't it?
Zadie?
That's right.
He was a head of state. There was a revolution brewing, an assassination. Now, you're not comparing that with
this. Yes, I am. You see, my uncle heads an empire too, Dr. Cook. And somebody just tried to assassinate him. And when he finds out he's failed, he just might try again. From now on, I'm not leaving my uncle's side, you understand?
Mr. Connors reminded me of the Sheikh Zadie incident, Doctor, and I do see his point. Mr. Wheeler's importance shouldn't be underestimated.
We've operated on important people at Gulf Coast before, Doctor. It's a dangerous precedent to set. Permit concerned members of the patient's family in OR.
But the damage that another incident of that sort would do to Gulf Coast, Kevin. We survived Sheikh Zadie's assassination. Let's not press our luck. Now, understand Mr. Connors' concern. Please cooperate.
All right, Chuck, if it's all right with you, it's all right with me. Come on, we're wasting time. Connor, get out of that, will you, please? And into the correct OR attire.
Well, girl, where have you been? You've had the Deckers and the Marshalls and even a few strays like that one over there combing South Texas for you.
I was at a concert.
A concert?
Yeah, a country and western band, a new one. Kids my own age, they got together and they wrote their own music. And, well, now they're just starting to make it real big. I read about them in the paper and I figured I should go see them, you know, and maybe take some lessons. They can do it. Why can't I do it?
Well, I don't know if I like the idea of you running off, but I reckon a concert's a darn sight better than where we thought you might be.
Yeah, well, then the concert let out, and there I was, with no place to go.
Well, that's not unusual.
What isn't?
It's not unusual when somebody goes off with a half-baked idea. They are bound to come into a rude awakening, and you just had yours. You heard your music. Now, where are you going to sleep tonight?
How about here?
I was afraid of that.
Why not, Maggie? Let me just stay here and work like I did during the summer.
Not this time.
Why not? You liked the idea during the summer.
Lord, I have created a monster. Summer is summer. You are in school now.
No more school. I've had it. I'm quitting.
If you think there is any way that I could talk Max into letting you quit school and come to the city, well, there just isn't. And besides that, you would have to convince me first.
Well, that shouldn't be so hard to do.
Hard? Honey, that would be impossible. I have no intention of letting you quit your education to come and sling hash at Maggie's restaurant.
Look, being a waitress is just how I can make my living while I'm breaking into show business, oh. Maggie. Well, there is nothing for me in that school. What do I care about the 100 Years' War? It takes 100 years to read about it. And dissecting frogs? All I want to do is make music.
Well, never mind about any of that now, because I'm going to go call Max and let him know where you are. He has probably worried himself sick by now.
Yeah, well, you can call him if you want, but it's not going to change anything, because I'm not going back there. I mean, there's more than one way to get an education, Maggie. And I mean to get mine by living, not out of some dusty old textbook.
Elena. Elena. Now, I know what you do is your own business, but I have been where you are going. And if you knew what it was all about, you wouldn't want to go there. Making your living with no education is no bowl of cherries.
Yeah, but you're doing it, and you're doing just fine.
Oh, am I? Now, what do I have to look forward to? Okay, I'm young now, and Maggie's been real good to me, and I like working here, so I guess you could say that everything's okay. But how am I ever gonna better myself with not even a high school diploma? How am I gonna like waiting tables here for 20 years or 30 or 40?
Yeah, but you can get into something else.
Lena, I don't know how. Maybe that's something that you learn at school. Elena, you look at me if you wanna learn from my mistakes, not if you wanna copy them. And I mean all my mistakes, including the one I married. Down here. Go ahead. See if I can bring you something from the kitchen.
Hold on.
Would you let go of me? You've got no right to touch me.
What is this stuff about rights?
Just let go of me.
I want to talk to you.
Well, too bad, because nobody's listening.
Yeah, well, you're going to start listening, because you're not going anywhere until you do listen to me.
You're going to start making some sense? What are you talking about?
You're not making any sense, and I'm going to talk that into you. Now, look, we can stand here, we can dance all night, if that's what you want to do, or you can sit down, and you can listen to me, Elena.
Thanks, Maggie. Well, praise the Lord, she's safe. But I don't know how safe she's going to be when I get my hands on her. Yeah, I know. We'll talk about that. All right, look, I'll see you as soon as I can. Okay. Well, bye-bye. And I swear, if I didn't know better, I'd say that child was your sister, not mine.
Yeah? Why is that?
Because she's starting to wear on me as bad as you do. Worse. Well, just as bad anyway.
Listen, Max Decker, don't you start in on me.
Oh, no, don't take it personal.
I said don't start.
Okay, all right.
I'm just not up to fighting back tonight.
I know.
I just thought it might help take your mind off of, Justin.
Justin is sitting in jail. Who would have thought it?
Nothing that boy does surprises me.
This is jail. Justin? Rescuing Ricky from a burning car, that's one thing. So's a shootout to save Terry's, but that's all crazy stuff, but this is different. This is jail. I just can't imagine Justin just sitting there locked up. He's a man you can't tie down. You can't lock up.
Well, he's sure as hell locked away, isn't he? And he sure as hell brought it on himself.
I can't believe that I'm hearing what I'm hearing.
Well, you heard it, and it's the truth.
You're supposed to be his best friend. Are you saying that Justin Marshall shot a man in the back?
No, that's not what I'm saying, and I don't believe he would. But he sure as hell set himself up to look like he did it. I mean, think about it. Sneaking into Wheeler's apartment with that Winchester, shooting his fool mouth off about blood and debts and making Wheeler pay for Mike Marshall's suicide.
Yeah, I mean,
we'd have known like we do, what would you think, huh? Especially since he's standing around in spitting distance of the crime.
None of that is evidence, Max. They can't penalize him for that. I don't see how they can even hold him.
Why are you so all fired, hopped up about him being locked away? Is it because you don't want him to suffer? Or maybe you'll be the one that's suffering if he's locked away where you can't get your hands on him.
Now, what kind of dumb talk is that?
Oh, I just remember how concerned you were when Brother Justin got himself shot. You remember that? And how anxious you were to get him out of that depressing old hospital bed and into a nice bed at your house?
Nothing happened that
night. Oh, sure, I believe that.
Absolutely nothing happened. I just fixed him the best dinner he's ever had, that's all.
You mean your maid did?
I did, honey, with my own two hands. Just like I fixed for you and Stryker. But then, after that glorious dinner, I put Justin to bed, all right. In the study, where he slept like a baby all night long, by himself.
You sure you didn't rock your baby to sleep just a little bit?
Whatever Justin and I had 10 years ago has changed. He's like a brother to me now.
Rena. Oh, Rena. Something tells me that your brotherly feelings are just a mite different than mine. I gotta tell Kate.
Hey, Kate! Kate, hey, Maggie called. Got some good news.
Justin.
Rena. Rena, be honest with yourself. I always did like your fun and your games.
Yeah, me too, with you.
The part I could never take was the closed-in part. The part where I belong to you.
Look, honey, you're a big boy now, you know? What makes you think that I'm gonna try to own you?
Well, the fact that I know you, Rena. I remember you from the old days, where Rena is the Empress and everybody does exactly what they're told or catches hell.
I always manage to keep my subjects very happy.
Have you? Where's Kevin? Where did I go 10 years ago? No man wants to be owned.
I get it. Fun and games, that's all right, but anything more is...
There'll never be anything more. Not for me. The trouble is, Rena, that while you're reaching for my body, you want all the rest. The rest belongs to me. Now, if you're interested in fun and games,
not.
And I think you should go back to your own bed. Could be fun.
No, it wouldn't be, darling. They need more.
You always did. Busted us up 10 years ago. We were just kids. I think it would break us up again.
the papers that we need. I guess it's time we were on our way, honey.
Yeah, let's go in and help Elena and Justin pick up the pieces.
Kate, you hold together now. Come on, honey.
Won't me.
Max is leaving the ranch now. He'll be here in about an hour.
Well, that means you have 55 minutes for your pearls of wisdom, because that's when I'm getting out of here.
Well, maybe putting something a little warm in your stomach will make you see things a little different. Got you some refried beans, some rice, and some chicken enchiladas.
The Kate Marshall approach, huh? Good hot meal takes care of everything.
Now, Elena, nobody is saying that a hot meal solves any problems, not even Kate Marshall. What it does do is it puts you in a frame of mind where you can start thinking clearly. Come on, Nita.
Eat it. It's a hell of a lot better than you're gonna get on the road. You know what you're gonna get out there? Junk food. And junk.
What?
Junk. Dope.
You think that I'm gonna set foot off the ranch and turn into a dope fiend overnight?
They don't start out as dope fiends. They get into drugs later on to cover up the fact that they've turned themselves into whores.
Look, I don't know what you think I am, but...
Well, listen, I could sum that up for you in a couple of seconds here, Elaine. I think that you're a fool. Wait a minute. Sit down. You've got 45 minutes left, all right? Listen, people do not go out on the road to become whores. They want to be a whole lot of other things, except for the fact that, see, there's a lot of kids out there, and a lot of them are talented, and a lot of them have educations. Do you read music?
No, no.
That's what I thought. Now, supposing somebody was to want to hear you sing. Elena, why don't you, will you sing this for me?
I told you I can't.
Oh, that's too bad, because the girl right behind you can. She can play the guitar, too. And she's just as pretty as you are. So then what are you gonna do? You're gonna try and find a job, except there aren't any available. But see, you wanna be on your own, right? And you wanna be independent. So then, what else do you have left to sell?
I would never.
No, don't ever say never, because that's what everybody says.
Look, you're making it sound dirty and dangerous, and it's not. I mean, there's nothing more beautiful than standing up in front of people and making them sad and making them smile by how I use my voice and what I'm singing.
Yeah, and everybody is just dying for you to come out and step into your spotlight, huh?
Here we go again.
I mean, what do you think? You're going to be playing this standing ovation? Who's heard of you? Who knows who you are? I mean, does any... these guys over here do? I mean, how would they know it? By word of mouth? Maybe the chickens told everybody, you know, the ones you've been singing to at the ranch.
Don't start pulling your big city stuff with me, okay? Look, I know that if you work hard enough and you get enough experience, you can work your way to the top. I mean, Dolly Parton did it, and Crystal Gayle did it, and Loretta Lynn did it. I mean, all of them came from the country, and none of them had any more than I did when they started. Look, I'll send you a postcard from Nashville.
You'll never get past Shreveport. They'll cut you down in Carthage. You know, you could make it. Maybe you could.
What?
If somebody helped you out, somebody told you when you were ready to go.
Yeah, but who's gonna do that for me?
Me. I'll help you out, Elena. I'll teach you how to read music, how to sing a song, how to sell it to the audience. If you want to make it. If
what?
If you go back to the ranch. You stay in school till you graduate.
Look at the EKG, will you please?
Try and stay clear, if you will, please, Connor.
Do you really think I want to interfere with your work?
Of course not, but you're unfamiliar with OR procedure. You're likely to be affected by what you see here. All I'm saying is stay out of the way. For your uncle's sake.
Does he have a chance?
The bullet hit a rib, shattered into a number of fragments. There's lung damage and internal bleeding.
How much damage? How much bleeding?
A significant amount, Connor. The serious part is one of the bullet fragments lodged itself in your uncle's heart. We have to retrieve that fragment and the others and repair the damage they've done. It's going to be a long night.
Can it be done?
Well, that depends whether your uncle has the endurance to give us the time we need.
Alex has always had the strength it takes in the past to do whatever has to be done.
Well, let's hope he has it now. He's going to need it. Scalpel.
Join us each weekday at this time for the continuing story of Texas.
Dr. Melton, 392.
Any word on Alex yet?
Dr. Melton, 392.
No. They're still operating. Still waiting. Thank you.
Mom, would you like a cup of
things are in Alex's suite. We had everything moved there. Except for what we put on the yacht for the honeymoon.
Dennis, does she have a key?
I don't know. Mom, do you have a key to the suite?
A key? I have a key. Yes. It's in my purse.
Never mind. Here, Paige. Take mine.
Thank you, Vicky. Dennis?
Mom, we'll be back in a while, all right? Vicky, would you mind staying with Mom?
I'll be here.
Thanks.
I had a purse and a very pretty coat. My key is in my purse.
Iris, don't worry about it. I gave Paige mine.
You gave her yours? I didn't realize you still had it.
We all need something to hold on to sometimes, and I suppose as long as I had his key, I had hope for Alex and me. And I suppose giving it to Paige is my way of giving up that hope and giving Alex to you.
Oh, Victoria.
Iris, I pray he lives. And that you have the life that you've waited for together.
Oh.
Texas, starring Beverly McKenzie.
Rib spreaders. All right, go ahead. Say you found a pericardial tamponade.
Just before you got here, the whole pericardial sac was filled with blood. I did a pericardial centesis.
Good, that was quick thinking. How long do you think he was in there, sir?
Almost from the moment he lost consciousness in the ambulance.
Brain damage?
Maybe. We can't worry about that now. He may be all right.
Uncle Alex, you've got a letter.
Number.
I'm gonna find whoever did this, I swear it. But who could have done it? Justin Marshall.
Scissors. Sponge. More suction, but
his pressure's low.
He's going to kill him. He had that old carbine with him.
Mike's rifle?
Yes. And he was ready for it. I could see it in his eyes. In fact, killing me would have been easier than making the choice that he did.
What choice? What do you mean?
He said my death wasn't worth it. So he threatened to take my life. Take Iris.
Probe.
Here's the track of the bullet. Sponge. Clamp.
No, Justin had his chance. He met Alex face on and then backed off. Why would he turn around and shoot him in the back later? No, it doesn't make sense. Not Justin. But then who? Curtis? No, he wouldn't have the guts. No, it had to be Justin. I can't quite believe it. Even Alex couldn't believe it.
We're ready for bypass.
Aorta is clamped.
No! Hold
it. What is it?
No!
What can we do?
No, not Justin, not him.
But look, he even had the rifle, sir.
No, don't you believe it. No, I knew his father. I loved his father. No, shoot a man in the back? No. No, not Mike Marshall's son.
All right, please, no. That's enough now. Please move out of the way.
Gotcha.
To shoot a man in the back who could be sick enough, desperate enough. Damn it, if it wasn't Justin, who could it have been?
Some answers. We're in big trouble.
Give me a break, huh?
Break hell, I'll break your legs. You screwed up the whole deal. You screwed it up.
Wait a minute, man. Wait a minute. I didn't screw up nothing.
Why'd you have to shoot him, you dumb creep? I told you to shoot over his head. I wanted his gratitude, not his funeral.
Shoot him? I didn't shoot nobody.
Oh, yeah? Well, you tell that to the cops when they come looking to put a murder rap on you.
Murder?
Yeah.
Yeah, if Wheeler dies from the shot that you took at him, pal, you're gonna get the murder rap. You got that? Murder!
Well, I'll send you a card from Nashville, okay?
You'll never make it to Shreveport. They'll cut you down in Carthage. You could make it. Maybe you could.
What?
If you had someone helping you out, somebody told you when you were ready to go.
And who's gonna do that for me?
Me. I'll help you out. I'll teach you how to read music, how to sell a song, how to work with an audience. If you want to make it. If
what?
If you go back to the ranch and you stay in school till you graduate.
Maggie. Elliot Carrington.
Yes, I remember. You're Dennis's father.
Right.
It's real nice to see you again.
Thank you.
Table for two, is Dennis?
No, I'm eating alone tonight. Dennis is at a wedding. His mother's marrying Alex Wheeler.
Do you know, I completely forgot about that. Well, if you'd like to eat right here, our special tonight is chicken enchiladas.
Oh.
They're pretty good.
Well, that sounds fine.
Jeff?
Well, welcome back from Nashville. You look the same. I got an extra chair over here.
Thanks. Hey, Jeb, why do you want to help me so much? Hey, what's in it for you?
I just got a big heart, that's all. I want to let you make a big mistake.
You wouldn't want to let me, huh?
Will you stop with this hard case? Now, you're really a nice kid.
I'm almost 18.
You're still a kid. So am I. I don't think anyone gets beyond that. Everybody makes mistakes.
Yeah, but if I don't try at all...
But if you try and you don't have any experience behind you, you're going to fall flat on your face, Elena. Then what are you going to do? Go back to the ranch with your tail between your legs? No, you're not going to do that. You got too much pride for that. I know that. What's left, then? The streets. Now, you know what happens out there. I can help you put an act together. I could maybe write some songs for you, too. That way, you got something, you know, when you're ready to leave home.
Well, then you see, you think it's okay that I want to leave
home.
Well,
it's okay when you're ready, but before then, it would just be plain stupid. Look, there's a lot of stuff happening out there that you really don't know
about.
Well,
I don't know anything, do I? Well, that is really nice, you know. I mean, you don't like me at all. I can see that.
I like you.
You do?
Yes, I do. It's just that you upset me sometimes. That's all.
I do?
Yeah. You're like an itch.
Well, then, you really do understand that I want to be a singer.
Yeah, I do. I really do.
And you're really going to help me? I mean, really?
Yeah,
but how are you going to do that? I guess I could come into Houston and visit you at the hospital, but how are we going to get together?
No, you're going to see me at the ranch, not in Houston.
But how?
Listen, I'm going to tell you how serious I am about helping you out. I'm going to postpone the surgery.
Oh. Jeb, Ginny told me how bad your heart is. I mean, that's crazy.
What's crazy, Elena, is letting you go out and do something foolish. That's what's crazy. Now, listen, do we have a deal here or what?
Okay, the deal is that I go back to the ranch, and if I do, you're going to help me put together a real career, right?
Now, no little side trips to the city. No more packing your bags up and disappearing, all right? And you stick with that, Elena, and I'll stick with you. All right? Out on the ranch.
You got yourself a deal, partner. But it's only till I turn 18 in January, you hear? Because come January, I mean to make my own decisions and live my own life my way.
Oh, you drive a hard bargain, ma'am. Eat your dinner.
Listen, I don't know anything about Alex Lurpee, shut up! Now you're trying to weasel out of it. Man, if you lost your mind, Winners in Gulf Coast Hospital have to hold you right through him. Oh, man, I was right here all the time. It wasn't me. I've been here since sundown. You were right where you were supposed to be, up in the Trend Building, and you fired that shot.
No!
Instead of firing her like I told you, you hit him. You shot him in the back, you jackass, and what the hell's the matter with you?
But I didn't, boss, I didn't!
You were so stinking drunk, you couldn't manage to miss him like you were supposed to. But no. No, no, I know what it was. You couldn't resist that twisted little impulse you got. The one that makes you want to hurt people. So Wheeler falls over with the bullet to his back and you feel great. Is that what happened?
Somebody really shot him? Hey, man, it wasn't me. I was here. I was right here.
Yeah? That's what you wanted me to say for you the last time, too. Now look right and get this. You be straight with me and I'll help you get out of it. But if you don't, you're gonna swing before I ever do.
Oh, no, man, no. You can't let me take it back to Huntsville, man. You can't. I was right here. I was right here. I was.
Okay. So you don't remember doing it, so it was an accident. But accident or not, pal, the police are going to come looking for you. And you're going to need a lot better excuse than the one you just gave me. Because they don't listen very good.
Cops. Oh, no, man. Listen, man. Man, you ain't going to turn me in, Clipper. Come on, Clipper, man. You ain't going to turn me in.
No, I won't turn you in. Whether you shot him or not, you're safe. For a while.
A while?
The cops picked up Marshall for the shooting. Got him in the World Building garage with that old carbine he keeps in his trunk.
But this is like you planned it! It's going okay!
But I didn't want Wheeler to get shot, you turkey!
But we're okay. I mean, they gotta question him, man, and they gotta check the gun, don't they, huh?
So how long do you think it'll take him, genius? It won't take much of a ballistics expert to realize that what got Wheeler didn't come out of Marshall's gun.
But maybe it did. Maybe Marshall did shoot him.
But if he didn't...
I couldn't look at me! I didn't shoot the guy!
Marshall's rifle doesn't match the bullet. They're gonna come looking for a second rifle. No, I don't think we want him to get yours, do you?
No, no.
Good. Now go get it.
Sure. Sure, you got a good place we can dump it, huh?
I got a great place. Just get the rifle, huh? Well, what the hell are you waiting for, Christmas?
It ain't here. It ain't here. I don't know where it is. It's gone. Boss, it ain't here.
That's the last piece for now. Any other fragments, we'll have to wait for a second operation. Have that cleaned up, please. How's he doing?
So far, so good, but I agree with you. I don't think he could have taken much more.
We've gotten the fragments most likely to do any harm, Kevin. I agree. The others can probably wait. The fragments are clean. Where do you want them?
There's a police officer waiting out in the hall, Bernice.
Just a minute, may I see them? Are you thinking what I'm thinking?
They're going to be hard to identify.
There's not even enough there to reconstruct the bullet.
No, but there's enough there to almost kill your uncle.
Shall I take these outside?
Let's leave that with the police right now, Bernice. I have a patient on the table. Let's close it up.
Okay. All right, get that rifle over to ballistics. Harry just called. They got most of the bullet out of the victim. He's on his way over with it now. Tell ballistics I want those fragments reconstructed as much as possible. And have them check it out against this here.
It won't match.
Right.
Last time that rifle was fired was when my father committed suicide.
Sure, sure. Go ahead.
Yes, sir.
Well, that finishes us here. So your lawyer shows up for your questioning.
My lawyer? Mm-hmm. He seems to be here now. Becker?
Justin? Damn it, Justin.
Thanks for coming, Stryker.
What'd you expect, boy? Officer, if you don't mind, I'd like to speak with my client alone.
You can sit right here.
Thank you. I want to ask you one question, son. And I want the truth, you hear? Did you do this damn fool thing, or didn't you? Now, tell me straight.
No, Stryker. I didn't do it.
Don't you lie to your lawyer now, boy.
I'm not. It's the truth.
It better be. I can't defend you unless I got the truth in my hip pocket. You understand me?
You don't believe me either, do you?
I don't know what to believe yet. You are a mighty likely candidate for this shooting, you know. Running your mouth off to everybody about how you were gonna get Wheeler sooner or later? Word got around. That, together with them finding you in the garage of the World Building, with your daddy's rifle. What the devil were you doing down there, anyway?
I wasn't out to kill Wheeler.
That's not what I asked you, boy.
All right. I was out to hurt Wheeler, but not what you're thinking. I was in his office during the wedding.
He know you were there? Breaking and entering.
I won't deny it, Stryker. I was trying to get a look at his private files. Thought maybe he had some dirty deals that he was cooking up.
You didn't find anything, did you?
No.
A man like Alex would be a damn fool to try any dirty tricks with all the business he had. Should have had more sense.
Should have done a lot of things, Stryker. I should have realized. I should have realized a lot of things. How could I have been so wrong? Stryker, I have been wrong about Alex Wheeler all along, haven't I? All along.
What happened, son?
After they arrested me, they took me up to where the wedding was. You should have seen their faces. They blamed me. All of them. Everyone thought that I shot him. Everyone. Son could shoot me in the back. He stuck up for me. This man that I have hated
that I've blamed, have been blaming all the time. All the time, Stryker.
He was a good friend of your daddy. He respected Mike.
He said that. That's exactly what he said. All the time, I thought he had contempt for my dad. Hearing him defending me. Because I'm the son of a man that he respected so greatly. I'm so ashamed.
Easy, boy, easy.
All of them think I did it.
Maybe now you understand how Alex felt being accused of something that he didn't do.
But he absolved me publicly. I owe him at least that much. Set me up. Do whatever you have to do. I have to get over to the hospital. I have to tell Alex that I understand now. I have to ask for his forgiveness.
Justin,
I have to give him mine,
Justin,
before it's
Justin,
too late for the both of us.
Justin.
Stryker. My father died before I could tell him what needed to be said. Please don't let me fail again.
Well, that's all we can do for him right now. Keep him intubated until we're sure his blood gases are stable. And Bernice, we need to get the PO2 results down to the recovery from him. Thank you, too. Bart, synthesis. Very quick thinking.
Thanks. I just hope it wasn't too late.
Kevin, I heard you mention that before. Do you mind explaining what that's about?
Well, the sac around your uncle's heart filled with blood. Surrounded by that fluid, the heart could not pump against that pressure. Add to that the collapsed lung, your uncle may have been anoxic before we even started to operate. There could be brain damage.
Oh, no.
His vital signs are still very weak.
I know. I'll stay with him myself. Well, thanks again, you two. I think we're a great team.
Thanks.
It's good to hear. Thanks.
He's right,
Bart.
You know that? Very quick thinking.
Kevin, is Alex going to be all right?
I don't know, Ryan. All we can do now is wait and see.
How long before he comes out of the anesthetic?
About 30 minutes, maybe less. I'll go down to recovery with him, at least until then.
I'll come with you.
Okay. Ryan. I don't want you to build your hopes up too much. When a man is shot in the back with a high-powered rifle,
That's right, he was shot in the back. Damn it, it just isn't Justin's style. But then who? Who could it have been?
help me write music, that means that I can eventually sing my own stuff, right?
Right.
You mean I could eventually work in a club and sing music
alone?
Look. Now, Max, cool down. Don't be too hard on her.
Don't be too hard on her. She ran away from the ranch.
Come
you know
on
how much
now, Max. Listen, if you go and talk to her with this attitude, you're going to undo all the good that that nice young man is doing.
What good?
Well, he's talking her into staying home, for one thing. He's going to help her with her musical career.
Her musical career? Maggie, I don't think you're playing with a full deck. I don't want her involved in any of that.
What do you want? What do you want, Max Dicker? You want her out walking the streets of Houston? Is that what you want?
One thing has got nothing to do with the other.
It might come down to that. Now, you just don't know.
Maggie, he's going to fill her head with all kinds of fool nonsense.
Listen, what is wrong with having a few ideas and a few dreams to fill her months there at the ranch? Now, come on. If you're smart, you'd be... I'm on this young man's side. If you were smart, you would be, too. Because he is buying you time.
Time for what?
Time for Elena to grow up, to get a little older, a little wiser. Maybe even fall in love with a nice young man. Quiet down that bee she's got in her bonnet. Oh, come on, Max. Go along with it. It's not going to do any harm, and it might do a lot of good.
Beer in the house?
Yeah.
Hello, Elena, Jim.
Hi, Max.
Hi, Max. Mind if I join you?
No lectures?
No lectures. Enough's happened tonight already. I need some peace and quiet myself.
Well, what's happened tonight, Max?
Well, I went to Alex Wheeler's wedding. Jerry's boss, he's gonna marry Dennis's mother.
Oh, yeah, heard all about that. Well, at least there's one person in Houston that's happy tonight, huh?
Yeah, well, not at this wedding. The groom got shot.
Are you the wedding?
No, I'm not kidding. Guess who they arrested for?
Who?
Justin Marshall.
Oh, no. Now, what did he have to go and do a damn fool thing like that?
Justin didn't shoot Alex Wheeler, did he?
I didn't say he shot him. I said he got arrested for it, and that's all I said.
I'm sorry. I couldn't help overhearing. I'm Elliot Carrington, Dennis's father.
Hello, how are you? I'm Max Dicker.
Did I hear you say Mr. Wheeler was shot?
Yeah, that's right, in the back.
Lord, tragic. Is he dead?
Oh, I don't know. They rushed him over to Gulf Coast Hospital. I guess they're still working on him.
Well, I'm glad you told me. Poor Iris, how terrible this must be for her.
Yeah, Justin doesn't feel too terrific either.
Well, if you people would excuse me, I think I'll go over to Gulf Coast Hospital.
Gulf Coast, that's right.
Yes, I may be able to help Iris.
Well, she needs her friends around her now. But you come back again real soon now,
yes,
you hear?
I'm sure I will. Thank you.
What a thoughtful man. Now, he's a real gentleman. That's what he is. Paige, that was so thoughtful of you, getting a change of clothes for Iris. Well, poor thing, she looked so frightened sitting there covered in all that blood. Oh, here she comes. Are you feeling better?
Yes, thank you.
Let me take this.
Was there any word on Alex while I was changing? Well, why is it taking so long?
Mom, they said it would be a long operation.
Yes, but not this long. Something must be terribly wrong if it's taking this long. I know something's gone wrong, Dennis.
So what does that prove? I mean, so the rifle isn't in there. That doesn't mean you didn't use it. But I did. I never even left the trailer. You're telling me you don't remember doing it. That's what you're telling me. I was drunk. Yeah, too drunk to remember shooting him.
I'd have known him, man. I'd known if I shot him. Nobody gets that drunk.
No? Well, you were sure as hell too drunk to remember what the hell you did with that rifle.
No!
Well, then where is it?
I don't know.
You don't know. You probably left it in the building you shot from, or somewhere away, along the way back here.
I don't know. I don't even remember.
Well, you better start remembering, Birdbrain. You better come up with where you left it fast, and you better find it before the cops do.
But what if I don't even know where it is?
Now, look, Pinhead. You listen and you get this straight. The cops are gonna find that rifle, you understand? And when they do, they're gonna check what store sold it, and then they're gonna come straight to me. Now see if you can figure out this part. Guess who I'm gonna pass them on down to, huh? They're gonna be knocking on your door in a minute, right, as soon as they find that rifle. So maybe you better search your memory real hard and see if you can come up and think where you left that rifle, right? Now I hope you're not too drunk to get that part straight. You got it? Damn it. Where's that rifle? Where is it, man? It's gotta be somewhere. The rifle! Where's it?
He still needs the respirator? There's no sign of spontaneous respiration. I'm not taking him off till I see him start breathing by himself. He's not lightening up at all.
He's not what?
He's not coming out of the anesthetic. Dr. Cook, I have the report of the blood gases. His PO2 is really low.
Thank you, Bernice.
The lung you repaired is expanding well, Kevin, but there's no sign of spontaneous respiration.
That'd be triggering. Sounds good. Any reflux?
No.
Any reflux? Excuse me. Pupillary response. Alex, can you hear me? Ryan, talk to him. See if he responds to your voice.
Sure. Alex? Uncle Alex? It's me, Ryan. He's not answering. But he's still under anesthetic, right?
He should have been out of it by now.
But you said his heart's working. You said his lungs are working, right?
We're doing that for him, Ryan.
But you did repair the damage, right?
Ryan. The brain sends signals to the heart and lungs. His cerebrum may have suffered too great a loss of oxygen. The brain is very sensitive to such a loss. Sometimes it can't recover.
What are you trying to tell me?
That your uncle has slipped into a coma. All we can do is leave him on the respirator and I'll see if he comes out of it.
You mean he might not?
I'm sorry, there's no way of knowing, Ryan. Could be hours, days. Could be never. As I say, all we can do now is leave him on the life support and hope that the body will heal itself. I'm sorry. We did all we could.
I know. I was there. Well, since my uncle can't take care of things himself, I guess that leaves me in charge now. Thank you, Kevin. You saved his life. As I know you tried to save Zadie's.
Well, let's hope this turns out better, shall we? I'll go and tell Iris.
No. You need it here. Please, stay with my uncle. I have a man outside. I'll tell Iris myself, huh?
I just heard. I came to see if I could help.
Oh, Elliot, you've always been kinder to me than I've deserved.
I care for you, dear lady.
Oh, I'm sorry. Do you know these people?
Yes. Would you excuse us for a moment?
Oh, I don't want to go far, Elliot. We're waiting for word.
No, not far at all. I just have one small question.
Yes.
I gather from Dennis's reactions that you never told him about Alex being his father.
No. Alex and I promised you that we wouldn't say anything for at least a month, and we'll keep our word.
I knew you would. I wasn't asking because I feared betrayal, no. Well, it's just that I would like to help you through this terrible time, but that would be awkward if Dennis knew, and so I'm glad he doesn't. Well, now, how is Alex doing?
I don't know.
But it's been so long.
I know. And the longer it takes, the more afraid I am for him. He just can't die.
Oh, no, no, no.
Elliot Carrington is a very dangerous man.
Iris?
Oh, Ryan, Alex, it... Oh, no. No, oh, my Lord. He's dead.
Yes, he's gone. I'm so sorry to have to tell you, Iris.
Join us each weekday at this time for the continuing story of Texas.
How is Alex doing?
I don't know.
But it's been so long.
I know. And the longer it takes, the more afraid I am for him. Elliot, he just can't die. Oh.
I can't help feeling that Elliot Carrington's a dangerous man. He could be a very dangerous man.
Because he knows you're Dennis's father, right? Iris.
Oh, Ryan. Alex. No. No, no. Oh, dear Lord, he's dead.
Yes, he's gone.
Oh!
I'm so sorry. I have to tell you this, Iris.
Come, sir.
Oh. Oh, no. Ryan, did he ask for it? What did he say?
I'm sorry, Mrs. Belmont.
Nothing?
He never regained consciousness. The operation was very long. He lapsed into a coma. Iris.
Oh, Ryan. Oh, Ryan.
I'm sorry, Iris. I wish.
Oh, no. There are no wishes left. No more wishes. Oh.
Iris.
Oh, me. Vicky. Oh, Justin,
what are you doing here?
Texas, starring Beverly McKenzie.
What is he doing here? He can't be here.
Iris, please.
He should be in jail. Don't you have police in this town? Why hasn't he been arrested?
I was. I posted bail. I had to get out of there so I could be here so I could speak to Alex.
No. Never hope. Please, someone get him away from
Iris,
here. Get him
Iris,
away.
Iris, I understand how you
just
feel, but I know I've been wrong. You have to help me. I have to apologize.
Apologize.
I have to beg his forgiveness for blaming him for my father's death all these weeks. Please, you have to help me before it's too late.
It is too late. He's dead. You've killed him.
Dead. Alex is dead.
Yes, he's dead, and you killed him.
You killed him.
I'll see you pay for this. I'll see you dead for killing Alex.
Justin, son, I think it's time we got back to the police station.
Why? You paid my bail, didn't you?
Come along now.
No, I have to think.
Look, you have no choice now. I made bail when the charge was attempted murder, but the charge has been changed. You've got to surrender yourself again.
Changed?
I'm afraid so. Now, look, there's nothing you can accomplish here.
Changed to murder?
Yes. Now, look, they may not even allow bail.
Please. I didn't shoot him. I didn't murder him, Starker.
I know that, but we have got to play this game according to the rules. I didn't do it! Justin! Justin!
What can we do now?
Well, we've got to find him. We've got to convince him to give himself up. When the police start to hunt, they may begin to use their guns.
Oh, no.
Look, the first thing we got to do is get your mother home. Come along, honey.
You aren't. You can't be if you're so concerned about Alex's murderer.
Iris,
And you can't be any friend of mine either. I never want to see you again.
Iris.
Doctor, I'm supposed to go off in a few minutes. If you're going to be here, I'll go outside and give my relief report.
All right, fine, Bernice.
Thank you.
All right, how did Iris take the news about Alex being in a coma?
That's not what I told her.
Excuse me?
I told her Alex had died.
You what? Say that again. You what?
Don't worry, I know what I'm doing.
You mind telling me what the hell you think you're doing? It's bad enough what we have to tell Iris. But to leave her no hope.
I know. I hate the fact that she's suffering more than she needs to, but believe me, I know she'll agree to my purposes, all right?
I'm listening.
Okay. My uncle's in a coma. Now, you say it may last weeks, months,
just a minute, just a minute. I said days or weeks. Heaven help him if it's months.
Okay, okay, but look at him. He's helpless. He's completely vulnerable. He's unable to defend himself. So it's up to me to make his decisions and to protect him from whoever's trying to kill him.
Well, it certainly wasn't Iris.
Of course it wasn't Iris. I had to make his death real. Right now, it's the best way we have, the very best way we have of protecting him. As long as the whole world thinks he's dead, the killer won't be tempted to finish the job.
How do you expect to keep up this pretense? He's here. He's alive now. How are you going to keep that secret?
The only way I can, with your cooperation.
With my cooperation?
Mm-hmm.
Ryan, for heaven's sake.
I need you to sign a death certificate.
You.
And after that, you're going to have to get hospital clearance. I want you to arrange a private suite for him. I want you to get him in under another name as a newly admitted patient.
I see. Just how many laws do you expect me to break?
I expect you to help me keep him alive. Now, that's it. That's your duty as a doctor, right? Okay. We'll register him under Arthur Wesley. That's W-S-L-E-Y. We'll keep him under wraps until I can find his assassin, or until he recovers well enough to make his own decisions.
Got all the answers, haven't you, Ryan?
Mm-hmm.
Well, what about Iris? I don't suppose I have to tell you how dangerous
okay,
that grief can be to her.
Okay, I'll take full responsibility for
Iris. Responsibility? What about some pity for Iris?
If I can protect Alex until he recovers, if we can bring him back to Iris, I promise you, she'll forgive me for whatever was necessary to bring that about. Now, will you help me?
What about his business?
His will makes me administrator of his estate. I guarantee that I'll keep things just as they are.
So you can do that?
Mm-hmm. I can delay probate indefinitely. Dr. Cook, now I appreciate what I'm asking you to do is extremely difficult for you to go along with, but if you don't agree to it now, right now, it'll be too late. Alex is going to be at the mercy of whoever's trying to kill him. Do you understand?
Well, I still don't see why we can't tell Iris. Save
no,
a little
no,
bit of this
it's impossible.
For heaven's sake, man, why?
Because she couldn't fake her grief well enough to convince everyone that Alex was dead. Besides, you want to stay by his side. That'd be dangerous, very dangerous. That'll leave the murderer straight to him. So we have no other choice now. Will you help me and help Alex?
Ryan, I can't.
So, you put your conscience above Alex's life, right? Well, you did that once before, didn't you? When you resisted my efforts to protect Sheikh Zaidi, remember? Well, he's dead, Kevin. If you don't help me, you're gonna have Alex's blood on your hands too. You got that?
This was good of you, Stryker. I felt so helpless, I don't think I could have found my way home. Thank you.
Well, I had to do something to ease my guilty conscience.
Alex Wheeler's been my friend for 30 years. I certainly was sorry to see his life snatched away like that. But God help me, somewhere inside me, I was not sorry that the other man in your life was gone.
You know, Stryker, Alex's death doesn't change anything for me, really. He was already gone out of my life. I lost him the moment Iris Carrington came to town. And at the wedding, my lord, the wedding. At the wedding, I finally admitted that to myself.
Lord, it tore me up to find myself hating an old friend like that. Maybe I can remember him the way I thought of him before I found out that... Strange. Him going off first. I lost a lot of evenings wondering what was going to be happening between you two when I was gone.
Nothing. Nothing at all. But I have a few of my own memories to recall. Forgive me that, Stryker. Forgive me.
What a performance.
She ought to be on television. Forgive me, Stryker. Forgive me.
Emmy Award stuff, if you ask me.
I respect her grief. So should you. It's nothing to make fun of. It's real.
Oh, sure it is, honey. As real as her double life in the back streets of Houston.
Oh, stop it, please. Rena, stop.
I'm sorry. I didn't mean to upset you.
You know, you can't always control who it is you love. Oh, my dear, I hope you never find yourself hung up on the same cross as your mother's been hung on.
No way, honey. I never betrayed Kevin while I was married to him. Never. I've got my daddy's straightforward character, not my mother's sneaky nature. Come on, honey, enough talk about her. We've got more important things to worry about, like finding Justin before the police.
Max, thanks for the lift. Good.
Max, I'll be in a second. I just want to talk to Jeff for a minute. Jeff?
It's late.
Don't you mean it's early? I mean, look.
Well, I thought I was through with these all-nighters when I quit my band. I hope you're not going to be a bad influence on me.
Well, that depends on just how good an influence you are on me. Hey, Jeb, listen, before I go in, would you tell me if I'm holding this cord right? I've been practicing, but here, look.
What? Oh, that's
no good,
awful.
Huh?
No, it's not good. What? Look, what? It's not that difficult. You're playing an E there. You don't have to play that. It's a very simple chord. All right?
Okay.
No, here. Your wrist. It's in the wrist.
Okay.
So, okay, try it.
Oh, yeah.
Huh?
That's nice.
Yeah, it is. Listen, you're gonna have to start working on your attitudes, on your professionalism, you know? You gotta learn to read music. You gotta learn to read it on sight so that you can sing a song like you've been singing it all your life. You probably won't even use your guitar when you get to singing and performing.
Well, when am I going to be ready to perform?
Oh, will you slow down? Will you take it easy? Will you take it step by step? Do it right.
And did you take that advice?
No, I didn't take that advice. That's why I almost killed myself. Look, don't repeat my mistakes. And listen to me when I'm talking to you. Don't be playing that thing.
Okay.
Elaine, I don't think you're serious about this at all. I think that we just should call the deal off, all right?
Jeb, I'm sorry. I am serious.
Yeah, well, you better be. And you got to work on your personal life, too, because that's just as important. You got to work on that just as hard as you're working on your music, because that's where your music comes from. You know that? Let me ask you, you want to have character in your music?
Of course I want to have character.
All right, well, then you got to have character inside yourself first.
Well, I've got character.
You've got a start. You've got a solid background. But you've got a lot of self-destructive tendencies. Are you aware of that?
Like what? Like not enjoying getting up at 4 o'clock in the morning to feed the cows?
No, like hanging around with a certain creep named Billy Joe Wright.
I don't hang around with him.
Well, that's not what I heard.
Well, I don't care what you heard. He doesn't mean anything to me. He's exactly what you said he was. He's a creep.
Okay, fine, then. Then we should never have to mention his name again around here, okay?
Well, you won't hear me mentioning it. Hey, you're not hurting, are you?
What? No, what? I'm fine.
You know, Jeb, I never got a chance to thank you. Well, you're making a really big sacrifice for me.
Look, I wasn't crazy about going under the knife.
Yeah, but the sooner you do it, the sooner you'll be well.
That's what they tell me.
You know, nobody's ever done anything like this for me before.
Look, I'm just doing what I want to do. I'm doing what I think is best for both of us.
Well, I'm not going to disappoint you. I am going to work hard, and I'm going to have the right attitude, and I want you to be proud of me.
Okay.
Thanks, Jim. Good night.
Good night.
Daddy? I have something to say. Hope you can hear me. I had to come here and tell you I was... wrong. Wheeler, I was wrong. I swore vengeance against him for your death. I know you heard that, so I know you're hearing this too. He's just He's just not. He's not guilty. You hear me? I thought. I thought he held you in contempt, but. Oh, Lord. He didn't feel anything like that. He respected you. He told me so. He told me with his dying breath, he told me he didn't believe Mike Marshall's son could ever shoot him in the back. Any other man would have blamed me, cursed me. But he knew. I've been so wrong, Daddy. Blaming him for your death. He's innocent. I'm the one who's guilty. Not listening to you when you called that last time. Being less of a son than I should be. You forgive me. Your forgiveness, just as I beg Alex Wheeler to forgive me. I've been so wrong and crazy. Who is it? Grandma?
Thought you might come here. Stryker called me. He's looking all over for you.
I know.
Says you've got to turn yourself back into the police. And if Stryker says
so. You didn't tell him I was here, did you, Grandma?
No. Only because I didn't know you were. Now listen to me. You can't run away. I've heard about the trouble. Won't do any good. You've got to face up to it. Like the man you are, Justin.
Grandma, I can't go back. The police. I'm innocent. They all think I'm guilty.
Stryker doesn't.
Stryker doesn't. The judge, the police, the newspapers.
You look
Grandma,
at me,
I didn't
Justin.
Shoot him.
Thank God that's true.
I mean, you believe me.
I know when you're telling the truth and when you're not. I've always been able to see it in your eyes. And I know you're telling me the truth right now.
Thanks, Grandma. Thanks.
Kate says is not at the ranch. I don't know where to look for Justin now.
Well, don't you worry, Daddy. I know Justin. He'll go back to the ranch. He's just like all the rest of the Marshalls. When he's in trouble, he reaches out to his family, to his roots.
I suppose you're right.
Well, I know I'm right. I know Justin Marshall just about as well as I know myself. Come on.
Rena, honey, I know that you and Kevin are talking about a divorce. But that doesn't mean that you're going to go running after Justin Marshall now, does it?
Honey, I'm not going running into any man's arms. Never again. Now on, they'll have to beg.
Well, you know what I mean. It would seem perfectly natural, maybe, but it can't do anything but cause you more trouble. Now, as much as I love Justin, and yet love him like my son, I realize he's wild. He cannot do you any good. Am I so wrong? Oh, now look, baby, look at all the messes that he has managed to get himself into in just the short time since he's come back from Europe.
You can't hold that against him. That's not fair, Daddy. Sure, he might have acted like a fool, but he was a good fool. He was trying to do the things that he believed were right.
Even when he was dead
Regardless.
Wrong?
Regardless. Anyway, we know one thing for sure. He is not guilty of those murder charges. I mean, that's just a bum rap, and we can't hold that against him.
Oh, can't we? Even when his fool vendetta against Alex put him square in line to be accused, he has been acting out this pointless, crazy game against Alex until now he's the most logical one to be suspected. He has been begging for this, Rena. You know he has.
Honey, whatever Justin has done, he is still Justin. Daddy, honey, you are going to help him out now, aren't you? If there's anybody who can clear him of this business, it's my daddy.
Now, look, I will do as much for him as he's in my power. I'm not going to turn my back on my friends, idiotic as they are.
I love you.
Now, look. You do me a favor, down the road a ways. When we get Justin out of this nasty mess, promise me that you will steer away from any emotional involvement with the boy. Will you promise me that?
I told you I'm not looking, Daddy.
Well, I'm not telling you not to look. Just don't look in Justin's direction. That's all. As a matter of fact, as far as that goes, I'd be perfectly happy if you'd find yourself some good, steady man.
Oh, like good old steady Max Decker.
You could do worse. Hell, you have done
all
worse.
All right, all right. Can we cut the lecture now, huh? I think we ought to go back to the ranch and wait for Justin there. We've got to talk some sense into him before it's too late. Now, won't you quit lecturing me?
I'm going to lecture you as long as I'm alive. Thank you are my little baby girl, and you keep it.
Kevin?
No more hard sell, all right? I'm trying to think.
For his sake, I hope you think right.
Dr. Cook?
Yes, Leslie?
I'm just starting my shift. Are there any special instructions?
Well, his heart's in normal sinus rhythm, but there's no spontaneous respiration. Have a respirator put in his room, please.
Yes, sir. Do you know his room number?
Hmm?
His room number.
No. It was an emergency. We didn't have time to arrange a room. However, there's nothing more we can do for him here.
Okay, I'll call admitting and arrange for a room then.
Leslie, make that a private suite, will you? On the top floor. In the name of Mr. Arthur Wesley. Now, please.
Yes, Mr. Wesley will have private nurses around the clock. I'll make all the arrangements, okay?
Okay.
Kevin, look, I know this is tough on you, but, thank you. I really appreciate
it. Well, I like to think I can learn from my mistakes, Ryan. Leave security to the professionals. Where you'll have to make the funeral arrangements.
Mm-hmm. Make it private and safe in a closed coffin.
A Well, I think that would be wise, Ryan.
Yeah. Hey, look, I know you're still pretty dubious about this, but believe me, you won't regret it. I can't thank you enough for, well, putting your career on the line like this.
Thanks aren't necessary. There's no guarantee you'll come out of the coma anyway. So maybe I'm just telling the truth a little bit prematurely.
Iris, you have to rest.
No.
I have a feeling my nerves are gone.
Oh, Dennis, he's gone. He's gone.
Take it easy. Sit down.
No. No.
Paige?
I can't bear this any longer. It's never going to end, is it?
Here, Iris, take this, please.
I'm never going to see his face again. I can't believe that. I feel so alone. I'm going to be alone now for the rest of my life.
Mom, that's not true, Iris. You have a fine son over here to take care of you. And I'm here.
And you have me, Iris. We can forget our old differences and hurts. I'll stand by you. I'll do whatever I can. Whatever you need.
I think that pill is going to do the trick, though, Dennis. She looks like she's going to be able to sleep for a while.
I don't know. She's always been a light sleeper. Half the time, when I was growing up, I never even saw her sleeping. She was always propped up with a pillow under her, reading a book or talking on the telephone. I don't know. She's just never slept very well.
Well, she has a little help this time.
Wouldn't it be nice if she could just sleep for the next few weeks?
Yeah.
That way she wouldn't have to go through the pain of what she's going to be feeling. If she wasn't in enough pain right now.
Dennis, what about you, honey?
I'll be all right.
You are about to drop from exhaustion. You have been up all night worrying about her. You need some rest yourself.
No, somebody's got to be here in case she wakes up.
I'll be here in case she wakes up. Now make me happy, please. Go home and get some rest.
You sure?
Of course I'm sure. I won't leave her bedside, I promise you. See, I'm not even sleepy. Us artists get to stay in bed half the afternoon.
Yeah, well, I could use some sleep, you're right. Thanks for being so kind to Mom. And to me, too. Appreciate it.
You don't need to mention it. Times like this, friends are supposed to help each other out. Besides, I'd like it if you could think of me as more than that, Dennis. Part of your family.
We're going out to the car, son. You can get it out of the garage for us. I just, I'll stay a few minutes and make sure your mother's resting comfortably.
Okay, Dad. Paige.
You don't need to worry about her, Elliot. Like I told Dennis, I will be around to take care of her.
You will, huh, Paige? Why?
Why? I don't know what you mean.
I mean, I don't trust you or your motives.
Well, you better trust me, honey. Actually, you have to trust me, since I happen to know your little secret.
Now, what is it you think you know about me, Paige?
Hey, not so rough, would ya? Why did Iris divorce you in the first place, honey? Are you one of those closet wife beaters? Mild-mannered in public and a tiger when the lights are out.
This isn't a game. I won't put up with innuendos and threats from you. Now, what are you talking about, my secret?
Oh, Elliot, you wrinkled it.
Paige, I've been through too much already. I'll...
Whoa, you are a tiger, aren't you? Wonder if Dennis has inherited... Oh, silly, silly me. That's the secret. That Dennis couldn't have inherited anything from you because you're not really his father.
You know about that?
You bet I do. Do you remember when I asked him if he was really your son? Well, Iris told me the truth, Elliot. That he wasn't. That he's really Alex Wheeler's baby boy. The late Alex Wheeler.
Okay. I should have known a smart cookie like you would put that together. I'm sorry I got so carried away.
I don't mind a little passion from a man. Actually, I sort of enjoyed it. Thank you, Elliot.
Why are you mixing in this? It's none of your business.
It's free country. Now, if you'll excuse me, my friend needs me.
Hold on. That's not good enough.
No. No, it isn't, is it? Well, I guess we're just going to have to make some sort of an agreement then, aren't we?
What sort of agreement?
Oh, say that, I promise not to tell Dennis the truth about his patrimony. Specifically, that you are not his daddy. And I promise not to interfere with your relationship with him at all.
If?
That's the easy part, Elliot. Just don't you try to interfere with my relationship with him either. It's a simple trade-off. Is it a deal?
Hold on. What do you mean exactly? You want to be friends with Dennis?
Friends? Oh, honey. I plan to marry Dennis. I'm gonna let him catch me.
Oh, wait a minute.
And don't you dare try to interfere. For your own good, baby. Because I can hurt you a lot more than you can hurt me.
Oh, Shelley, come on in.
The office told me my patient was still in recovery. I wanted to see him up to his room. Still under?
No, he's not under anesthetic. He's in a coma.
Oh.
Listen, before I brief you, you remember Dr. Cook, don't you? Shelley was on Sheikh Zaidi's private duty staff before his operation. She has State Department medical clearance.
Oh, yes, of course, I remember you. Nice to see you again.
Doctor?
Did an excellent job for us before. I appreciated your discretion. Now, this is another high-security case.
I see.
What we want you to do is keep an eye on the patient, of course, but also see that no one besides Dr. Cook and myself sees him. Now, can you handle that?
Sure. But what if I can't talk unauthorized visitors into staying out?
Okay, I'll have a security man here for you, Ricky Decker. And that's the only other person allowed to be with a patient. Any questions?
I know better than to ask. Oh, well, there is one question. What's the patient's name?
Arthur Wesley. Now, can you handle all this, Shelley?
Oh, sure. Take him gently now. You and I are going to be spending a lot of time together, Mr. Arthur Wesley.
I hope we're doing the right thing, Ryan.
We're doing the only thing we can to keep him alive until I can find out who wants him dead.
Join us each weekday at this time for the continuing story of Texas.
Finished going over the trial matters with Rachel?
Yes, we're through.
Is she all right?
She's tired, but in control.
She certainly wasn't in control in the courtroom today, though, was she?
Oh, Mac, we all knew that Jason Dunlap's testimony would be difficult for her.
But we didn't expect her to go to pieces while Tracy was on the stand.
Quite frankly, I'm surprised she didn't go to pieces before today.
What do you think the net effect of the testimony was?
Well, I think we scored some points with Jason, especially off the number of times that Rachel went to see Mitch at the disco. I think we created also some doubt about Rachel's following Mitch to St. Croix because she was having an affair with him.
Jason seems to have some sort of grudge against Rachel.
Maybe the jury picked up on that, too.
What about Tracy's testimony?
No, it wasn't fatal.
How do you think the jury's going to interpret Rachel's crying?
They know she's pregnant. And they know she's been under a great deal of emotional stress. So I suspect they won't attach too much significance to that.
What's Rachel gonna have to face tomorrow? What's Colton gonna throw at her, do you know?
Thank you.
Hello, Mr. Assistant Mayor.
Hello, Blaine.
Gus said that you wanted to talk to me, Mr. Derrick.
Yeah. I feel really lucky tonight. But if you wouldn't mind giving me another kiss.
It wasn't the kiss that did it. It's because you walked into that blackjack room with all the confidence of a winner.
So help me out with my confidence.
It's a pleasure. Oh, look at that. Now you walk in there again with full of good thoughts.
I sure will.
Evening, Mr. Derrick.
Hello, Vinny. Aren't you dealing tonight?
Yes, sir, I am. I'm just on a break.
How are you doing?
Better than last night.
I plan to change that.
I don't think he wants you to be up to your usual sharp self tonight, Dave.
Blaine, as long as Vinny's taking a break, why don't you have a drink with me?
Oh, I'd love to.
Let me know when you're ready for action.
I'll get it.
It's Private Pop.
Hello.
Ewing, this is Captain Petroni.
Yes.
Can you meet me in half an hour?
Sure.
I'll pick you up at the entrance to the north side of the park.
All right, I'll be there.
You'll be warm.